Welcome student,
now we are going to take the next part, that is called civics. In this civics we have total 6 lessons and 3 lessons for our first semester, in which the first 2 lessons for this unit test. Okay. So this civics start in these books, that at page number 70 and 71, 68. The first lesson start on 16-8. Let us continue with this lesson so we can understand the meaning of this lesson. So there is the first title of the first lesson is introduction to the parliamentary system. So student, we have for our rule that system is called as a parliamentary system. Before 1947 we have British rule, which is unjust. So after severe freedom struggle we get an independence on the 15th August 1947, and after that, after 2 years of conversations between the prominent persons, they introduce this parliamentary system in India, which is for the welfare of every person and different societies. So due to there are the differences in India on a large scale, so to give each and every section of the society as a representations in the parliamentary system, they arranged it in a so manner that every group or a caste or different economically different peoples that have their representative in the parliament. So the welfare concept of this great personalities come into exist. So let us have there are some pros of this parliamentary system, while the defects of this parliamentary system. So let us have in go through this parliamentary system's consequences in this first lesson, that is introduction to the parliamentary system. So let us start for a reading and with the explanations. In this chapter we will learn a machinery or the system of government as a given in the Indian Constitution. These questions would lead next is the square, that is have some questions, that is, have you thought of this? What is a parliamentary system of government? In India, we have Prime Minister, but why there is no Prime Minister in United States of America? What is the difference between the parliamentary and presidential system of government? So here are different types of the government which in the different countries. In India it is parliamentary, while the presidential systems in the USA? These questions would lead us to conclude or to get the meaning. Conclude that every country has a different form of government before we go ahead to understand different types of the government system. Let us get the information about the main branches of government. Okay, the part of the government. So there are different branches of this parliamentary system which gives an understanding about this system. The first is the function of legislature is to make law. The executive implement of the law and the judiciary provides the justice. Okay, here are three systems. That the function of the legislature is to make a law, the executive implements the law, and the judiciary provides the justice. So here are three branches, main branches: legislature, executives, and judiciary. Legislature makes the law, executive function implements the law, and judiciary provides the justice. The function. So students, write down the parliamentary system mainly consists three bodies. Parliamentary system mainly consists three bodies. First, legislature. Write down first legislature. Write down the function of legislature, that is to make a law. Legislature, make an arrow and write down to make a law. Okay, the first branch of the government. Write down second. Below that, write down second. The executive. Okay. Write down, give an arrow in front of it. Arrow, and write down to implement the law. And next, in the third line, write down judiciary system, JUDICIARY, judiciary system. Arrow, make an arrow and write down the function of this judiciary system, that to provide justice. Okay, so in parliamentary system we have three main bodies, that is legislature to make the laws, executive to implement the laws, and the judiciary to provide the justice. The functions of these organs, their jurisdictions and limitations on their power, and the interrelationships between these organs are decided by the constitutions. So these three bodies are controlled by the constitution. Okay, because these constitutions give them a jurisdiction and limitations of their power through and interrelationships between these organs. These are decided by the constitution. So these three branches follow the constitution.
विच गिव्स देम द डायरेक्शन ओके एंड कंट्रोल देम. इट इज इन नेचर ऑफ देयर इंटर रिलेशनशिप्स. दिस इज द मेन वर्ड दैट इज द इंटर रिलेशनशिप. ईच बॉडी हैज ए इक्वल रिलेशंस विथ ईच अदर. गिव एंड टेक इज इक्वल. सो हियर द टर्म कम्स द इंटर रिलेशनशिप्स. ओके इंटर रिलेशनशिप्स दैट डिटरमाइंस द सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट अडॉप्टेड इन पर्टिकुलर कंट्री. देयर आर टू मेन टाइप्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट दैट्स आर फॉलोड. पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम एंड प्रेसिडेंशियल सिस्टम. सो इन द होल वर्ल्ड देयर आर मेनली नाउ डेज देयर आर टू systems which are followed in the world, that is the parliamentary system and presidential system. Parliamentary system of government, so here we come to get the information or introductions about the parliamentary system. In the parliamentary system, we have mainly three branches, that is making legislature, executive and judiciary. Let us have informations about this parliamentary system. The parliamentary system of government developed primarily in England. This parliamentary system primarily developed in England. The English constitution is an unwritten constitution. The governance is carried out in accordance with tradition and customs and conventions. Conventions means the agreements. Okay. The British Parliament is an institution that has evolved over a period of time. The parliamentary system of government having roots in a parliament is considered as the contribution of England. So the system parliament is given by the England. India has adopted this parliamentary system. We can see some broad similarities in the parliamentary system of the England and the parliamentary system of India. But when looked at the institutional level, the Indian parliamentary system is different in its content. Let us understood the characteristics of the Indian parliamentary system of government in India. The parliamentary system is the system of governance. The legislature of the central government is known as the parliament. The Indian parliament is composed of a president, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So in the parliament system, it is a law making body which is referred as a law making body and contains three main parts, that is President, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. These both three parts of the Indian Parliament makes the law. Members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. The number of members in the house is fixed. It is depends upon the population. elections to the Lok Sabha are held at a regular interval, that is the period of 5 years. All political parties contest these elections. The party which gets more than a half of the seats is considered as a majority party, and the majority party formed the government. Sometimes when no party gets a clear majority, some parties come together to form a majority and they can establish a government. This kind of governments is known as a coalition government. Today Modi governments come into exist and having the power of India, but this party, that is Bharatiya Janata Party, has a clear majority. So these the Modis as a person or institutions have a large effect on this government. In this way, candidates directly elected by the people become members of the legislature, and the party in majority gets a chance to form the government. The leader of the majority party, so the party comes in a majority, the leader of that party becomes the prime minister. He or she select the candidate for ministerial positions from among his colleagues. So the prime minister chooses his colleagues through his party members who are get elected in the election. The prime minister and the council of ministers chosen by the prime minister together forms the executive in the parliamentary system of the government. In parliamentary system, the executives have a dual responsibility. As an executive, they have to implement law. Second, as they are the member of legislature, they also have to fulfill responsibilities of the legislature. So they makes the law and executive implement the law. The prime minister and the council of ministers is responsible to the legislature for all their actions and policies. It means that council of minister has to work with the legislature. It is for this reason that the parliamentary system is known responsible system of government. So here comes the meaning of the executive body, that the parliamentary system is called known as a responsible system of government. Another distinct characteristics of the parliamentary system of government is collective responsibility. What? Collective responsibility. So here no one person can get the responsibility or power in his personal hand, but this the governmental responsibility is a collective responsibility. Whole ministerial body has an responsible for their act, the government act. Decision taken by the ministry is considered as the decision of the government. The entire council of the ministers is the responsible for this decision. So any minister any minister in his ministry declared the decisions. So, but the whole council of ministers is responsible for this decision. In the next two chapters, we will see the with the example how the principles of the collective responsibility is brought into practice. In the parliamentary system, the executive is the dependent upon the confidence of the legislature in them. So every government must have a confidence of the legislature in the parliament. This means the Council of Ministers remains in the power till it enjoys the support or confidence of the legislature. If the legislature feels that the executive does not work in accordance with its wishes, it removes the executive from the power by the passing a no confidence motions against the executive. No confidence motion is an executive effective tool of the keeping check over executives. In the parliamentary system form, parliamentary form of government, the legislature is a supreme institution. So in the parliamentary system, legislature is a supreme institute. Underline this, okay. Elected representative of people express demand and aspirations of the common people in the parliament. The parliament decides upon the issue of public welfare, since it is the house of representatives of the people and expresses a sovereign authority of the people. It is considered as the supreme body. We will stop here. In the next lecture, we will continue with these lessons, and after that, we will complete these lessons into the next lecture. Okay.